Hello everyone, as I promised that in this video I am going to discuss the problem on cuts. So before starting this, you should have a basic idea of cuts. Many of you already have, but still those who don't have, there are 52 cuts all total in a deck. So out of those 52 cuts, we have 4 shoots. So if you divide 52 in 4 shoots, you can clearly understand that each shoot contains 13 cuts. Now, what are those shoots named as? They name as club, diamond, heart is in red, so I'm trying to represent by this method, heart, and spade. So club is of black color, diamond is of red color, heart is of red color, and spade is of black color. So it should contain 13 cards, as I said. So this 13 cards, what are those 13 cards? They are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, J, Q, K, S. So clearly you can see that this 2 to 10, they are known as number card, as their numbers are pointed there, right? So next one, JQK, they are known as face card. Please be very careful, S is not a face card, only JQK is known as face card. Now these four cards, JQK and S, they are known as picture card. So many times we are going to use this word. So now, again I am just repeating, what's there? Total 52 cards, 4 shoots, 13 cards in each shoot. So 13 cards in each shoot, and the cards are this one. Now based on this, if I will do couple of sums, just check. The first sum is probability of a black king. First, how many black shoots are there? 2, club and spade. So, and each shoots contain how many king? 1. So, 2 shoots, it will be 2 into 1, 2 cards. So, 2 favorable outcome, total cards 52. So, answer is 1 divided by 26. Next one, probability of black card or king. Or is given, be very careful. Now, how many black cards are there altogether? 13 from here, 13 from here. So, total 26 black cards, right? And how many kings are there in all suits? Each suit contains one king. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, total black card or king, 26 card, 26 black card, 4 kings. But check, in the black card, already I had taken the kings of this black card. So, those 2 cards are common. So, I have to subtract that. So divide by 52, it will be 30 minus 2, so 28 divided by 52. If I will divide by 4, the answer is 7 divided by 30. Next one, probability of neither heart nor king. Neither heart nor a king. So I don't want heart. So how many non-heart cards are there? 39 cards. So from that 39 cards, also I have to subtract king. That means one card from each shoot. So 39 minus 3, so it will be 36, right? So it will be 36 divided by 52. If I divide by 4, it will be 9 divided by 13. Right? Next one, probability of spade or an ace. How many spade cards are there? 13. And how many ace are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Each card contains one ace. So this J is known as jack. This Q is known as queen. And this K is known as king. So we have 4 ace cards, right? And spade 13. 13 plus 4, 17. But ace of spade is coming twice, So the subtract was, so it will be 13 plus 4 minus 1 divided by 52. 17 minus 1, that is, so if I divide by 4, it will be 4 divided by 13. Next one, if I discuss probability of Jack, King or Queen. Probability of Jack, King or Queen. It should have 1 Jack, King, 1 Queen. So 3 from each should. And how many shoulds are there? 4. So 3 into 4 divided by 52. So answer is 3 divided by 13. So that's from the cards. Now if I'll move to the problems of coin tossing. If I toss a coin, I will get the outcome head or tail. If I toss a coin 2 times, I will get the number of outcomes will be 2 to the 4, right? So how we are going to represent the outcome, just check. I want to write H and T 2 times. First case, I am going to write H in front. Next case, I am going to write T in front. So these are my 4 outcomes. If I will toss a coin 2 times. Now, if I toss a coin 3 times, what I will do? I am going to write the previous 4 outcomes. Previous 4 outcomes, just check. I am going to write again 2 times. In the first case, I am going to write H in front. Second case, I am going to write T in front. So this way you will easily remind this. So 3 times total number of outcomes will be 2 to the power 3, that is 8, already I have discussed. Now if I ask probability of 2 heads, 2 heads mean exact 2 heads. So just check how many outcomes are there, 1, 2, 3, these 3 outcomes only. So 3 divided by 8. Next, probability of at least 2 heads. I have already discussed the concept of at means it can be 2 heads or 3 heads. So how many outcomes are there for 2 heads? 3. With that I will just add the outcome of 3 heads, that is 1. So answer of this will be 4 divided by 8, that is 1 divided by 2, right? Probability of at most 2 heads. Now that means it can be 2 heads, it can be 1 head, or it can be 0 head. 0 head is also possible because all tails are there, right? What is the probability of at most 2 head? It can be 2 heads, that is these 3 outcomes. It can be 1 head, that is 1, 2, 3, these 3 outcomes. It can be this one. That is, the answer is 7 divided by 8. Probability of at least 1 head. At least 1 head, just check, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so it is again 7 divided by 8. So from now on, please do remember, probability of at least any event, probability of at least any event, that will be 1 minus probability of no of that event. Probability of no of that event, that is probability of no head. So what was the probability of no head? That means tail, that is this case. So it will be 1 minus 1 divided by 8, the answer is 7 divided by 8. So probability of at least any event, that will be equals to 1 minus probability of no of that event. Please remember this thing. So this will further, if you will proceed, you will get all concept, 2 heads, 3 heads, 1 head, at most, at least, whatever it is. But still, if you have any doubt on cards and this coin tossing, please let me know in the comment box. That's it. Thank you.